Right now, the day's biggest news stories from a Vegas perspective. This is the Vegas Take with Sharp and Shapiro.
All right, welcome back. It is the Vegas Take, Sharp and Shapiro. By the way, coming up at the bottom of the hour, Kid Poker, Daniel Negreanu, one of the best poker players in the world the last two decades, will be joining us. While he was a big Andrew Yang fan, I'm sure he still is, Andrew's dropped out of the race. We'll talk to Daniel about that coming up here in a little bit. But we all know the story, the national story that makes Major League Baseball, particularly the Houston Astros, look awful. They're cheaters. Make no mistake about it. They are cheaters. Managers have been fired. Heads have been rolling. And now, the Houston Astros are going to be facing a lawsuit. Mike Bolsinger was a major league pitcher. He's a journeyman, and he got lit up by the Houston Astros. I believe it was back in 2017.
Yep, August 4th of 2017.
So now he's hired an attorney. The attorney's name is Ben Meiselas, works for Geragos and Geragos in Los Angeles. They are suing the Houston Astros organization. Ben joins us right now on the line. Ben, thank you so much for joining us. How are you?
Good. Thanks for having me on the show.
Appreciate it. Okay, so this is a very interesting story, and it could be setting a precedence. So talk to me about what led up to this lawsuit.
What led up to this lawsuit, obviously, is the Houston Astros cheating scandal. But specifically from the data we received, we know that as part of their cheating scandal, they would bang on this trash can from the dugout to the batter to signify what pitch was being thrown.
Wow.
We can trace the specific bangs that took place during each game. And we know during this game that Bolsinger pitched August 4th, 2017, the fourth inning. 12 of his 29 pitches there were bangs, 41% of his pitches. He's an off-speed pitcher. Our data shows that essentially every one of his pitches, they knew what he was pitching before the pitch happened. They crushed him, and he was specifically fired that game as soon as they crushed him. And for a journeyman pitcher, each appearance, each pitch counts.
Sure.
And for someone like that, that game mattered more than anything, and he got fired. We know he was definitively fired because of that.
And just to expand on what you mean by crushed, he had 29 pitches in one-third of an inning. He gave up 4 runs, 4 hits, 3 walks. Did he get anybody out at all?
There was, I think, one person out while his wife watched. His friends, he's from Texas, so his wife was there in front of 55,000 people and millions of people. It was horribly embarrassing.
Wow. Okay.
He had to leave the country and play in Japan.
So you have no evidence of devices, but what you're saying is the players, managers in the dugout were making noises and hitting garbage cans and stuff. Is that accurate?
No, we actually have the evidence of the devices. I mean, you know,
you do.
The commissioner's report, we know specifically what happened. But we know that there were cameras that were taping it that were then sending the signals to
Whoa.
The dugout. And we have admissions of players. I mean, players have been confronted, you know, in the past week and said, you know, what would you say to Bolsinger? And they'd say, hey, we're sorry. We wish we could take it back. But, hey, there's nothing we can do about it. In fact, the Astros are meeting today and huddling with the owner who wants them all to just shut up and stop admitting to it because they've just admitted to it, with the pending lawsuit. But they should admit to it. They should be transparent.
Of course.
Yeah, just get over it.
And isn't that technically illegal for the owner to tell the players to shut up?
Now, Ben, let me ask you this.
Yes.
In regards to these devices, what can you tell us? Can you get into any specifics with the evidence, other types of evidence that you have with what they were using for the signs?
Well, I mean, what we know, you know, is pretty much rooted in the commissioner's report. So we know that there were taping going on from the outfield. We know that the signals were being decoded, the specific ways the symbols were being decoded, whether that was through AI, artificial intelligence, or through some other means. It was being sent rapidly. The bang would then signify whether it was going to be an off-speed pitch or a fastball. A bang would usually signify an off-speed pitch. So a pitcher who throws really, really fast, it may not impact as much because you could just wipe a batter away with speed. But for an off-speed pitcher who relies on deception, when the deception's taken away, you're just a crappy pitcher.
Right.
And that's how batters were able to unload off of Bolsinger. And, you know, there have been other pitchers who were affected, but no one particularly like Bolsinger.
If you're just joining us, we're speaking with Ben Meiselas. He's with Geragos and Geragos, a pretty prominent law firm in Los Angeles. His client is Mike Bolsinger. He is suing the Houston Astros. Bolsinger got lit up in 2017 by the Astros, and now his attorney is telling us that, yeah, they have full-blown proof that this was going on all the way back to 2017. So my question to you, Ben, is this. If not for this controversy and what took place in postseason this past year, would you guys still be doing this?
The short answer is we're doing it because we haven't really received enough answers. I mean, one of the problems is the commissioner's report was decent, but it certainly didn't go far enough. We know that the Astros have still been lying. They tried to blame it as a player-driven thing and blaming it on players who are no longer with the team, right? Just blame the other dudes who are no longer here, and let's let the owners and management get away with it. And so, frankly, my client just got pissed off, and he said, I'm tired of these lies. You really affected my life. I'm doing this for myself, but I'm also doing this for the people. And remember, a major component of this lawsuit is that he's demanding that the $31 million in postseason bonuses improperly earned by the Astros actually go to charity and not to himself.
So this is very, very interesting. Usually in a situation like this, you know, if it's a professional athlete, say, for example, like Cristiano Ronaldo and his situation with the woman, there was just kind of a settlement out of court. It sounds like Mike Bolsinger, your client, isn't interested in that. Do you think that this will set a precedent for other potential pitchers or other potential teams or managers or what have you that will come out of the woodwork if Mike Bolsinger in this case is considered successful and it's not settled out of court?
I mean, I hope so, because I like exposing fraud, but then again, I hate fraud. So this is a particularly egregious example. So I hope that other teams aren't going to follow the lead of the Astros and cheat and think that they can get away with it. Think about it. In addition to $31 million in postseason bonuses, they've increased their value of the team by 18% over the year they won the World Series. So by about $300 million, the valuation of the team increased. So if the penalty being imposed is under $5 million, which is the current penalty, to the average person, that's like a $5 penalty. Would that deter your conduct, you know, ultimately to get millions of dollars if you were only going to be penalized $5?
Probably
not. This is really about exposing the conduct. Mike was sitting back. He saw the commissioner's report didn't go far enough. He says, what can I do? My life has been severely impacted, and I want to give back to the communities as well, in addition to my own damages. So let's expose this further. Let's see where this goes. And that was that led to the filing of this lawsuit, which is groundbreaking, but makes a ton of sense, you know, and we should prevail.
Have any of the Astros attorneys or legal representation reached out to you directly?
I haven't heard yet, although, you know, be mindful, obviously, we filed it, you know, 2 days ago. And all we've heard thus far is in direct response to the lawsuit. The owner is speaking with the Houston Astros today and telling them, shut up, stop speaking, stop apologizing, stop admitting to it. Those were some stories that came out this morning in direct response to the lawsuit, which, again, is the worst instinct. It's like the law of holes. Stop digging.
Right.
Stop digging. And at the end of the day, admit what you did. Forfeit the $31 million to charity of all places and move on and admit to what you did so that this never happens again. Stop covering it up.
Let's assume that dating back to August 4th of 2017, Mike Bolsinger on the mound, let's assume that that doesn't happen. I mean, how much money, this might be a tough question for you to answer, but how much money do you think that inning costed your client?
Well, you think about what pitchers make and what their, you know, salaries are. I mean, this is a big business and people make, you know, real money. And he had to move to Japan to play in Japan. His wife was pregnant at the time. She had to give birth in Japan. So his life was completely uprooted. And as Mike says, he's like, look, if I want to take personal responsibility for myself. If I fail, I want to fail on my own terms. But they took that right from me.
Right.
I've worked incredibly hard. This was an audition for me, and I could have succeeded.
Right.
So you can't tell me, hey, because, you know, you weren't the greatest pitcher in the world, that therefore your damages aren't enough. I worked hard, like every man and woman in America, at my job to get where I was.
Sure.
And you took failure from me. I didn't have control of that mound that day, and that's why I'm bringing this lawsuit.
Yeah, listen, I'm on your side. I agree with you 150%, so long as you have the evidence, which it, from what you're telling me, you do. But let me ask you this. You're suing the organization. What about particular players? Because, you know, and we're getting into the weeds here maybe a little bit, but Major League Baseball, you know, they put the manager up there on a stick basically and said, get the hell out of here. You know, the manager.
AJ Hinch was hired, fired pretty quickly.
Yeah. So, but what about player accountability? For example, if you have players like Altuve that is wearing a device allegedly that has been cheating, probably, I would imagine, I don't think I'm out of the realm of possibility, for years and wearing these types of devices. Don't you think a player like that should be held accountable as well and could be sued financially as well, not just the organization?
And the short answer is yes. And the longer answer is that when we file the lawsuit, we include what's called DOE, like John or Jane Doe, DOE defendants. And so we know the Astros organization was responsible. As you get through the litigation process, which is called discovery, when you want to name other individuals, other investors, other affiliates who ain't embedded the scheme, you know, you can do that. And in our complaint, we allude to the existence of affiliates who aided and abetted. But for at this time, you know, it was important that we, you know, file given the evidence that we had. We thought the timing was important given the lack of information and transparency out there. And then we can always add DOE defendants in the future.
What are the? How much money are you guys asking for? Have you gotten to that point yet?
We haven't gotten to that point, but the big number that we wrote into the complaint is the return of the postseason bonuses,
right,
which is $31 million, and then right, that money be paid again, you know, to charitable causes, specifically to children's charities and to
that's
retired
great
player foundations.
Listen, that's great, and I think that's great that your client wants to do that. And by the way, we would love to have your client on this show at some point down the road. I know he's a busy guy, if he's available. But I want to ask you this. You know, moving forward now, with everything that's taken place here, how much do you think this damages Major League Baseball? Because this is really, in my opinion, this is worse than steroids, and I would imagine your client would probably agree with me on that. This, to me, this is 10 times worse than steroids. I mean, I kind of compare it to a professional tennis player, and the person receiving a 130-mile-an-hour serve knows exactly where the serve is going, knows exactly where it's going to be. It's the exact same thing, in my opinion.
And Brian, I would say this is worse because you have that 45 or 50-second time in between pitches to prepare
for the pitch. Yeah, I mean, this is so egregious, it's beyond belief. I would imagine you agree with that, Ben.
I absolutely agree with it, and the issue is it going to get much worse? I mean, I think there's been a lack of leadership within both the Astros, you know, and generally within the league right now, of accurately and transparently explaining to people, like, what happened and what's going to be done about it. It's the sweeping under the rug instinct and mentality that's led to some great investigative journalism, citizen journalism, who continue to expose it.
Yeah.
And so it's been incredible journalism at the expense of some horrible lying that's been taking place. So hopefully they're learning from this lawsuit, and we could, you know, move beyond this, learn from this, improve and make the game fair and restore integrity.
Let's assume that your lawsuit prevails and other attorneys or other players hire other attorneys for the same purpose. Is it possible that the Houston Astros could have to declare bankruptcy from all these different lawsuits of all these different amounts popping up, and that the Houston Astros organization is just done with Major League Baseball?
Well, I think that I don't know is the short answer. I mean, I think that Bolsinger's case is incredibly unique in the fact that you can directly trace his termination to very specific instances of cheating, which makes it unique and obvious, and all of the elements in a legal case, such as causation, you know, we're able to prove. You know, in terms of the broader implications, you know, for the Astros as an organization, they're handling this so sloppy, so completely wrong, that mm-hmm. the first thing they should do is just admit to it, apologize for it, rightfully fall on the sword that they cast in the first place, and they should start making amends and come up with a plan, because mm-hmm. it's, again, that cover-up mentality that led to the lawsuit, frankly.
Yeah,
had they done the right thing, had they reached out, had they talked about what they were going to do, instead of said, ha, 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 we'll pay this little fine and try to get away with it, you know, that's when people come out and say, no, we got to stand up. And, you know, Mike Bolsinger is a person who comes back and says, hey, I'm not gonna let this happen to me, to the league, to the sport I love, you know, when I started 5 years old picking up my first baseball.
Sure. Well, listen, Ben, make no mistake about it. I am 150% on your side. I'm glad you have a client that decided to do this, because I think it took some courage. I'm glad he's doing it. Down the road, Ben, if it's possible, we'd love to have Mike to come on our show and talk a little bit more about this in the future. But we really do appreciate your time. Thank you for explaining this to us. I hope you get these guys. I really do. And it's about accountability, and they need to be held to account. Thank you so much for your time, Ben. We really do appreciate it.
Yeah, thanks. Let's get them together.
All right, sounds good.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Ben.
I wish I could get a chunk of that lawsuit, by the way. Then I would really get involved. Ben sounds like a very, very competent attorney.
And he sounds very confident.
Very confident. Well, speaking of confidence, speaking of attorneys, and speaking of the courtroom, we have just learned some breaking news that the jury has now begun deliberating in the Michael Avenatti trial. We'll have a live report for you coming up next. You're listening to The Vegas Take right here on the all-new 101.5 FM, 720 AM, KDON.